Hey everybody, it's Bianna again, and today we're going to talk about taking care of your relaxed hair. So you've decided that it's best to keep relaxing your hair during this natural hair boom. That's okay, for now. Eventually, I want you to think about growing it out. I'm going to give you some tips in this video on how to keep your hair healthy during and after this process. The most important thing to remember when you've decided to keep a relaxer in your hair is that the consistency is everything. Sticking to a schedule for regular new growth touch-ups is essential. Every 6 to 8 weeks is average. 8 to 12 is okay as well, depending on your hair texture. I never recommend any sooner than every 5 weeks. This can cause overprocessing in the hair. Let's go over 3 important tips to keeping your relaxed hair healthy. Seek out a professional. So we were just talking about how important consistency is when it comes to sticking to a relaxer schedule. Seeing a licensed professional is the easiest and safest way to do this. Your stylist will keep track of when it's time for you to get a touch-up and also keep you on a hair care regimen. If you are trying to tackle this on your own by doing your own relaxers at home, not only are you most likely not using a safe professional product, but you are at high risk of overlapping the chemical on the hair, which will inevitably cause breakage. Even if a relaxer is the only service that you get done at a salon, it's worth it. A professional stylist can do a touch-up, deep conditioner, and trim all in one service. I have clients that only see me to perform these services once every 6 to 8 weeks, and their hair is thriving. Now let's talk about what you can do at home to take care of it in between. Proper conditioning. First off, shampooing and conditioning your hair at home when you have a chemical relaxer is essential. You can go and see your stylist every 1 to 2 weeks if you like, but let's assume that since you're watching this video, you're looking for a different option. I suggest at least every 1 to 2 weeks shampoo your hair either in the shower or the sink, whichever you prefer. Use a gentle, low alkaline shampoo and conditioner. I like Onesta personally. You don't want to use any products that will dry your hair out. Over-the-counter shampoos tend to have a lot of perfumes and silicones. Read your labels before you buy. Products that have no parabens or sulfates are best because they won't strip the chemical out of your hair. Shampoo twice and then follow with the conditioner. After applying the conditioner, put on a plastic cap for about 20 minutes. If you have a hooded dryer, sit under that. After doing your at-home deep conditioning, rinse the hair thoroughly. I like to use cool water. This ensures the conditioner is out completely while sealing the cuticle of the hair for more shine. Styling relaxed hair. Whatever you do, do not pull out your blow dryer and attempt to blow dry your hair when it's sopping wet. Let your hair air dry or sit under a hooded dryer until it is at least 80% dry. Then hit it with the blow dryer. Blow drying relaxed hair when it's wet will make it pull and stretch too much, causing it to break. Once you finish the blow dry, flat iron your hair in 1/2 inch to 1 inch sections. Once finished, be sure to limit the use of your flat iron to only 1 to 2 times per week. Wrap your hair every night to keep your hair styled. I hope these 3 tips helped you with taking care of your relaxed hair. If you have any other questions you would like to ask, I would love to hear from you. Thanks.